how things will improve and how things will change by industry. So only on those accounts, I understood that this was still a relevant conference. Furthermore, we have a lot of federal issues that are running around, including the SNAP funding, healthcare funding, CDBG funding. We have issues regarding Jones Act. We have issues regarding federal tax reform. So that's another reason why this conference is still relevant. And if that wasn't enough, last week, the court said that the board is unconstitutional. So my friends, if you ask me today if this conference is relevant, my answer has to be more than ever. So I really, really thank you guys for being here. Have a great day. Enjoy the conference. My really, really my thanks to everybody for being here and Paco for having me on this work. Have a great day and enjoy the conference. Bye.
A little bit this afternoon, I'm going to talk some about it now. I'm the CEO of MCS, which is the best healthcare plan in Puerto Rico. It's these things right here. Please, if you fill them up today, be careful. But if you spill them, please spill them on the triple S little thing for your ear. And you don't need any green on that show. Please be safe. Enjoy your dinner. So Promesa, as Congressman Dudley talked about, was enacted by the 114th Congress two Congresses ago. It's to assist the government of Puerto Rico. It says right there. So with that being the goal, then you have to sort of dig down a little bit further. What do you feel like it means? And you know, and so if you take sort of the basic definition of a promise, it's a declaration or an expectation of success. Something's going to improve. And what I see really Promesa is stark confirmation that economically what Puerto Rico was doing didn't work. It didn't work. It didn't work for Detroit. It didn't work for D.C. And it puts a very significant burden on the local government, on the board, and the private sector like us to try to work together to find the right way to do it. But armed with that, we need to sort of look through and say, okay, where is it going? As one of the first speakers said, the board was found to be unconstitutional. They have 90 days for the president to affirm the new seven board members. And in my sort of eyes, my simple way of looking at things, and that's sort of my goal here for a little bit of time together, is I'm going to sort of simply try to aggregate what do I think is the biggest sort of problems we have, and then the rest of today we hope we find solutions. But as I look at where we stand on the life cycle, there's four parts to team building. There's forming, i.e. they put the board together. There's storming, we go through some struggle. There's norming, we establish what the rules are. The team starts to work, and then